So isn't this great? You came back all the way from America to play in an interesting venue like this tonight, Tom.
Yeah. Paul Raymond used to own it. Paul Raymond Publication, who is men only in Men's World. I know because I used to buy them mags when I was a young boy.
Regular subscriber.
Used to
the
be.
The paper boy used to deliver
before
them for
internet
you.
Took off.
That's right. It was the only place you'd get it was either top shelf or in a hedge.
Well, we lived on a farm, and I'd go in and buy it. I'd do the dirty deed, you know, and not care. And it helped the rest of the band out, and everyone was kind of, you know, not so, aggravated.
You were the porn supplier to the band.
Yes, I was, and we kept it in a cupboard. Don't tell Mum.
What do you mean you kept it in a cupboard? Your mum must have known.
George, I mean, he'll be livid when he sees his interview, but we used to hide it in like the airing cupboard, like in the bathroom. But everyone went in there and had a
by
piece.
The immersion tank? We put the towels and the bed
exactly,
in it.
Yeah,
so you had your stash at the back
there.
We
had a stash, mate. It was a big stash.
Like Chronicles of Narnia, it was buried at the back.
There was a lot, mate, yeah. You know, everyone had the turn. Everyone enjoyed it, so there you are.
So listen, how was America? That must have been great fun.
I mean, yeah, it was grueling. I don't think we've ever actually... As a band, you know, going out there, work that hard, you know.
Yeah.
It was absolutely grueling, and I mean it. Like, gig, next town, gig, promo, gig, promo, gig. And, yeah, it was good, man. And I think the future looks good for us in America, because we ain't been there for 5 years, you know, because we had a bit of politics with our record company and stuff, and we did Coachella, and that was great. And, it's looking good for us out there, so hopefully we're going back, you know.
Were you happy with the shows?
The shows were great, and you know, we were middle of America, you know, in nowhere place. So once you start getting people interested, you're doing okay, you know.
It's exciting to go, because obviously America is such a big thing for bands to try and crack, and it's really, really hard, you know. And you've had an amazing couple of years here now. And Velociraptor last year was a real tipping point for the band, you know, because you've always been big, but I think last year with that album, you sort of surprised people.
Yeah.
But then in America, it's so big and it's so varied, the audiences. Is it exciting, almost that struggle of trying to crack it again as a band?
Well, the thing is, like, you know, like I said to Serge, you know, we were talking about it. It was like we've got something. It's not just like something to fight for, you know, and prove something. Because, you know, we've got Europe pretty much hands down now. And
you've conquered it.
Yeah, kind of. Yeah, we have got it. And we've been Japan silly amount of time. So, we've still got unfinished business in America. So, yeah.
And how different are the audiences then between this country and America?
They were pretty crazy, man. They were good. They were good crowds, and they were really into the band. There's a lot of proper, real hardcore fans as well that really give a damn about us, you know. So
was Coachella good fun? That's a
Coachella
cool festival,
great,
isn't it?
Man. Yeah, it was great, and we went in this tent and we just did it. You know, it was fantastic. Yeah.
So you must be, because you were out there like for 7 weeks.
Yeah.
You must be knackered now.
Well, you know, waking up at, you know, 6 a.m, waiting for Jeremy Kyle for 3.5 hours is horrible, you know. I mean, actually waiting for it, that's pretty sad, you know. But,
living the rock and roll dream.
Oh, I got this new steamer, right? I ordered it because in the early morning you see people selling things, so I ordered one. I said, I want one of them.
On those demos, where they do like anything, I need to have that, I have got a better life.
It come this morning, the buzzer went, I went down and I went around my apartment with a steamer, did the whole wooden floor, and I was sweating, I was ripping.
What do you mean, like a steamer cleaning the floors?
Yeah, well, it just cleans the wooden floor, it's good, you know, it gets all the crap off the floor and that.
Kasabian cleaners.
It'd be massive, mate.
And so what were the real things you were looking forward to getting back, like Sky Sports? Or?
Yeah, Sky Sports, proper sausages, white English bread, tea bags, good milk. That's about it, really. You know what I mean? So,
and you pleased with Leicester season as well? I'm a Southampton fan, so I'm made up.
Congratulations, mate. You deserve it, man. So, you know, we've got to sort the squad out and get it to go for next season. So, yeah, we'll see what happens. We spent a lot of money and... There's a lot of frustration going on, you know, because we've got an amazing fan base and that, and we've got loyal supporters. So we'll see what happens next season. I said we'd win the league last time, we'd piss it, and obviously it didn't happen. So there you go, eat shit. You know what I mean? It's my fault for predicting it. You know,
it's on you. It's on you, Tom.
Well,
you know,
it's my fault. But you know, I thought we were going to win the league, and it never happened. So that's life.
And so, what's next for the band? Are you going to have a little rest now?
We're going to have a rest, and then we're, and then go back out to the summer festival before you know.
Yeah, so, I know. Yeah. And then what about sort of new material and trying to find time to write?
Sergio's got loads of stuff written already. I imagine he has, because he doesn't never stops writing, you know. So I can't imagine when we're going to record a record. Not at the moment. Probably next year sometime, you know.
Does that feel crazy, just having your whole year mapped out? I mean, that's obviously what you dream of, success like that in a band.
Yeah, it just, you know, take each day as it comes, I suppose, you know.
I was asking our listeners this morning, right, some questions for you.
Yeah.
All right. And the first one, I think you'll like, it does involve Leicester City Football Club. And the question is, you can either have number one album in America or score the FA Cup winning goal for Leicester. It's a tough one.
It's ridiculous. You can't answer that for me. That's ridiculous.
I don't know what you've seriously thought about. It's impossible. I'm short-circuiting.
No, forget it. It can't happen.
They're two big, equally powerful events.
America would be good, but scoring a goal would be great. So I can't answer that one, sorry.
What about this one? What is your favourite biscuit?
In a packet?
Would it be maybe a rich tea? I mean, I'll give you ideas, or a Lincoln, or a Hobnob, or a Ginger Nut.
Probably. You know what? I like Viennese Wilds. I don't think that counts. You know, Mr. Kipling.
Yeah.
Yeah,
he makes exceedingly good cakes.
I don't know if it's classed as a cake. I'm not sure. You know what I mean? But is it a biscuit, Viennese Wild? You know what
no,
I mean?
I'd say that. What do we think? I think that's more of like a chocolate biscuit, to be honest. Yeah.
Listen, I'll tell you what. This is going to stun everyone. Breakaway.
I used to love those.
Breakaway.
My mum on a Friday would put them in my lunchbox if I've been good during the week.
It's wholemeal wheat. It's milk chocolate on the outside, you know. Get the bite into it, it's just lovely with tea.
Do you remember the jingle?
No.
Was it Don't Take Away My Breakaway?
That was Take Away, Don't Break Away.
Don't Take Away My Breakaway.
Oi. At the end of it, oi. Honestly, I swear, I remember that. Hey,
add it to the set list tonight.
Oi, yeah.
It can be in the sound check.
Breakaways, they're going strong, mate. They're a survivor, you know.
You're always a very mesmerising front man to watch. Ian Brown. No, you are, you're brilliant. And if you could be front man in any band, dead or alive, okay, you can get in a time machine and whatever, what band would you have loved to have been, apart from, of course, Kasabian?
Gene Simmons, Kiss.
Yeah?
Yeah.
When they did the makeup or when they...
Yeah, the makeup, selling toys, you know, the tongue, everything. What an experience, you know. Imagine being in Kiss, it'd be massive.
why not for the next album you bring out the kind of Kiss years for Kasabian?
We could do. My tongue ain't big enough.
Well, listen, thanks for answering the questions.
No worries.
Enjoy tonight as well. We're looking forward to it.
Yeah, thanks a lot, man.